from the 1980 Olympic gold medalist team. Play your game. Don't get wrapped up in taking a lot of threes, pounded inside to the big guy.
And away we go here at the arc. And the ball will be Valparaiso's to start things off. Our officials today, Ray Natilli, Roland Simmons, and Jeff Campbell. And Valparaiso will start with the basketball on offense. Derek Smith's one of 2 7-footers on this Valpo team. Trying to throw it inside, taken away by Luke McDonald.
Terrific rotation right out of that first possession on the double team in the post.
Now A.J. Green, the freshman for UNI, the son of the assistant coach Kyle Green. He is the highest rated recruit ever to sign at UNI.
His mother wanted to see him play.
She will get to. Here is Trey Burhau, a three from the wing off target. The long rebound comes out to John Kaiser. And now Valparaiso can reset. Talked about playing your game, but that's always tough to do against this UNI team because of how they dictate tempo.
You must throw the ball inside and demand the double team, as they have right there with Derek Smith.
And trying to fight through the double and puts it in.
That's the maturation of Smith's game from being a sophomore to a junior. Taking your time, not getting flustered.
Smith second on the team in scoring, the leading rebounder for Valparaiso. Now 9 to shoot for UNI. Here's Green, comes around Kaiser. At the elbow, the jumper at the end of the shot clock, no, and the rebound to Freeman. Freeman and Sackey, a pair of freshmen in the starting lineup now for Matt Lottick, giving them some speed. Now Freeman in over Burhau, that was way short. And Boulder able to save it. The shot clock down to 6. Sackey off on the 3.
Jordan, you're going to see a lot of action for Northern Iowa with no low post. They'll keep McDonald up into the high post area. He's a terrific passer. And speaking of terrific passers, how about Smith in this double team? He takes his time. He doesn't get flustered when the ball comes loose. Great finish by the big fella.
UNI trying to get on the board for the first time, 2.5 minutes in. 4 seconds to shoot for the Panthers. Green, the fadeaway jumper off target. Valparaiso resets offensively with Golder against Brown. Isaiah Brown, a lockdown defender for the Panthers. Now Freeman goes inside to Smiths in the post, muscles it up over McDonald. Derek Smiths with the first 4 points for Valparaiso.
Northern Iowa is going to need to get more people movement, more ball movement. There was first 2 possessions. It was A.J. Green taking tough shots at the end of the shot clock.
Now McDonald underneath against Smiths, and a foul is called.
We talked about play your game. Smiths, he thought about that 3 and then thought better. Kicks it out. They throw it right back in. And again, good finish in traffic by Smiths, but that's the idea of playing your game. You don't want to settle for a 3-pointer, albeit he was wide open. Go to your strength.
Derek Smiths really developing nicely now in his redshirt junior season for Valparaiso. But the other thing here is McDonald at the free throw line. Austin Fife was slated to be the starting center for UNI at the beginning of the season, but he's out for the year with medical injury, and so this has put McDonald in this position. When you're Valparaiso and you got 2 7-footers, Rich, I think they're trying to establish that early.
Well, they certainly are, and shout out to Austin Fife. Hope you get well soon, big guy.
Absolutely. Now they go to Soroya against the double. Kaiser underneath, can't get it to go. Soroya tips it in. Aume Soroya, the junior, coming in and picking up right where Smits left off.
We've seen very early that both Smits and Soroya able to handle the double team. A couple of nice passes out of it.
Wyatt Lohaus against a double. Now we'll pull it out to Burhau. Lohaus has dealt with injuries the last couple of years, now in his senior season and healthy. Feeds underneath, and Taiwan Pickford is fouled going up. Brings us to a timeout on the floor, but Valpo going to its bigs early. They have the lead early, 6-2.
When you visit St. Louis, you'll probably want to watch